Hey there, everyone. This is Ann Clemmer. Hey, I just got to ask you, do you feel like there's not enough love in the world? Well, you know, I'm kind of feeling that way sometimes, but not today. Let's see if we could do something about that. I'm here with Domino from StamperDog.com. Hey, let's get started. Stamper, come. You are going to love this, no dog. He'll be in here in a minute. And, you know, I'm going, oh, I know I'm going to make something with that, you know, those candy hearts. And then, like, where are they? But you know what I did do right? I got all the things from the sale on Friday. Yep, they're out in the mail. And I got all the sweet treats out in the mail. Phew, life is good. So, yeah. Whether you're watching this on the replay or you're here live like Amanda is from Panama City Beach, Florida. She says it's cold. Hold on. Come on, bud. Oh, yes. The security has showed up. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. So anyway. Oh, yeah. Deb, we want to know how's your mom. Yeah. Look at Mr. Shy Guys here. He'd never make it as a security guy. I don't know what it is that he does not like to look at the camera. Now, we have done some still shots of him, but yeah, he's just not working today. Well, you know, whatever. Oh, golly. Oh, so anyway, yeah. I love you too, bud. But he just wants to, he never wants to do this, but I did find something he doesn't like. Next time he turns around and thinks he's going to go and give me a little nibble, you know, I'll do it and we'll see how it works. Yeah, he's a little sweetie until he wants to go and we'll see what he does. Bzz. He does not like that sound. There you go. It looks like he's shedding, but he's not shedding. It's his hair sticking out. So anyway, have you seen those long, thin cards? Oh, golly. Hold on one second. Yes, when I was packing up the sweet treats, I came across those slim envelopes. I'm looking, do I have a catalog here? You know, I know I do, but where is it? No, those aren't envelopes. It's an envelope long and thin. It's like this, right? They're from the company sells them. He brought me in some of the sweet treats that I'd already cut up. Yes, he is growing fast. You know, he is almost as big as Stamper was. Well, Stamper was about 14 pounds and Domino is 10, but Domino's a lot shorter. So anyway, let's look at how we can go and make the some of those slimline cards. How about that? Now, I'm going to tell you on this one, we're going to use the thick Whisper White. Oh, basic white. Yeah. Oh, Kate. We have a new Kate. That is a popular name around here. Yes, it is. Ooh. My husband's having a hard time finding that. Okay, so this is 8.5. And because of the size of the envelopes, I think I'm going to make this, I was going to make it 7.25, but then that doesn't go in half fairly well. So I'm just going to go by 7. So the downside of this is you can only make one, but it's not like you won't use any of this over here, right? Let me go and it'll take me 5 seconds to get that. Bingo, that's it. He was heading my way. Here, let me cut this. See? Here, these are the slimline envelopes, right? And they're too long to get in here. 157981. See that? and you get 15 of them. And so since they're the same thing, everybody got one. So if they got the green, see, they're printed, they're lined on the inside. Here's a white. Now this is weird. Oh, that's because I have two. I was going, this seems thicker than this one. It's because I had two of them here. Yeah, and let's see if I have any. And then there's the gray. See, they have the same print, only all color coordinating. And I think we'll do this for tomorrow night. Now, I swore. See, I'm just going to tell you, I have been concentrating on the sale. I've been concentrating on getting those sweet treats out. I've been concentrating on a lot of things. So it's like, I don't even have all my stamp sets set up yet. Because, you know, as demonstrators, we can earn free stamp sets. So this is this right here. It's set on the back of the package. But was I looking at that? No. Paige, okay, thank you, Patty. You and Marcy are so great. You know what, Marcy? I was going to look that up to see if there's extra postage. And I'll put that on the blog tomorrow, probably. What size does it say? The size? No. But it does say on page 53 of the mini catalog how big these are. But I can measure it. And it is 3 7/8, which I remembered, right? 3 7/8 by 8 7/8. Now, here's the thing. You could make this like 7 1/2, right? And get an extra quarter inch. But you're going to lose some of that, you know, if you want to go and put you know, a lot of layering on here. I personally don't think that it's, yeah, I was thinking the same thing, Beverly. I don't think it takes extra postage. So we're going to make this 7, because you don't want to go like 7 5/8, because then it gets harder to go and split that up. So here we go. Done. We can use this for something else. I mean, look at, this is, oh, perfect. This is 4 inches wide. So just cut a half inch off here, and now you've got a little square card. Perfect. Oh, now I know what I'm doing tomorrow night. Okay, so now that we've cut it at 7 inches, now we want to score at 3 1/2. Now we're starting from scratch here. So. That's 3 1/2, and you can see where I scored it. And then I'm going to take this. I always score the thick, and I'm going to burnish it. Fancy word for bend it to your will. Yeah, fancy word for that. So, hey, did you have a nice weekend? Boy, these are long and thin. Here you go. See, look at, by making it 7 1/2, just that size. I'll back out a little bit there. Not much. See, you have enough room where you can, you know, you can put stuff on it and make it, you know, layered, and it's not going to be really, really thick in there. So since I don't know what I did with, golly, now I'm going to have to change up my thought pattern. Totally. I just grabbed this. Just grab this. I don't think it's the same size as a 10. I've got a number 10 here somewhere. Hold on. I do keep them, and it lasted. Okay, whoops, you saw my mess. Okay, here is a number 10 envelope. And here is this. So yes, it will be regular postage because it's smaller than a number 10. And it's not square because, you know, using that leftover to make a square card, that's perfect because that 4 by 4-inch square card will fit inside a standard quarter sheet envelope, and that way you don't have to pay any extra postage. And anything I could do to avoid paying extra postage, yeah, I'm on that page, aren't you? yeah, it's just a little bit smaller. So now, boy, this is great because I had a card in my head and now it's like, what am I going to do now? Well, I'm going to take the colors from this, right? I'm going to take the colors from that, right? If you're ever stuck for a color combination, you know, we might just do these two. So what two are these? I think that's Pool Party or a shade of Pool Party. And I believe it's Highland Heather. So on the back of these, see, if you look, woo, there you go. Yeah. How small can you read? Blushing Bride, Granny Apple Green, Highland Heather, Petal Pink, Pool Party. So let's try Pool Party and Highland Heather. Now I got the Highland Heather out here. There. We're going to use other colors too. Boy, when I look at in the dark over here. Oh yeah, okay. And we can make those gray. Yeah. See, brand new. Haven't even used this yet. Okay, but I'm getting ahead of myself. We can still use, you know, just because we're not using the stamp set doesn't mean we're not, you know, we can't use some of this, but we got to be careful which one we use. I mean, using the totally red one is going to be a little bit. Oh, hey, we could do this real red and purple. Because this, So how long is this? Are we doing purple and real red, or are we doing purple and pool? Ooh, okay. This might work. I don't like looking at this, but I think on a card it's going to be great. That's funny because technically if you read it, it's not supposed to. It's not supposed to. I tend to be a rule follower for the most part. Unless it's worth putting my neck on the line for, or like, you know, okay, let's face it. Who wants to go and mail some love to somebody and then they get it back so that the person has to get it maybe a month late? Sometimes when I've had mail returned for more postage or because the address is wrong or whatever, it can take up to a month to come back to you. So is it worth saving 12 cents or whatever the difference is? Yeah, no, I just rather, okay, you don't want me to use square, square envelopes without putting extra postage on it? Well, how about I just put a square card in a rectangular envelope, but we'll call it good. Golly, Nancy, I thought that you'd process different kind of paper. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, and talking about spreading the love, you know, when I was talking about that in the beginning, and if you're just tuning in, we are going to make a long, slim card today. And we're doing it from scratch. We're all making it together. So if you just want to chime in, yeah, that would be a good thing. Oh, yeah. Here's a button I need to push. It doesn't make any difference to anybody except for if somebody subscribes, it'll bark. So that could be you. So anyway, are we doing red? And are we doing this? Kind of looks sweet, though. I don't know. I have no idea. Because we are starting from scratch. Oh, yeah. Oh, you're not looking. So, what color boots? Well, you know, we could just do gray boots just to match the outside of the outside. Yep, gray boots. Gray boots, and I have an idea. You know, we may not get this all together, but you'll have an idea of how to make your own. So this is 3.5. This is, okay, this is 8.5. So divide that by 3. It's like, what is it? It's not going to matter, but let's say if we do 2.5, that's 7.5. 2¾, that's more. Yeah. Yeah, 2.5, 7.5, 2¾. Yeah, if we do 2¾, 7, that'd be 8¼. Okay. So we're going to cut this. I'm going to show you my idea here. I'm going to cut it. That won't work. Hey, if I don't do this right, don't worry about it. So, okay, so we're going to do it 3¼. Could I do this better? Yes. But seat of my pants. Yeah. Oh, yes. You know, and you have such a great sense of humor too. So it's 3¼ by 2¾. And actually we can go a little, we can go 2 7/8 because we have enough room here. We're just figuring out tomorrow's card together. Okay. Okay, so these are going to go on like this. See? One here, one there. And then it didn't have to even be even. 3¼. And yes, Nancy, when I sent your sweet treats, I included the cup of coffee for your son. Let's just go 3¼ by 3. And you notice I always push this right into there. Yep. I think it's time for a new blade. I can't wait until I get this all squared away here. Okay, so here's my next thing. Remember, these are going to be like this. This is going to be in the middle somewhere. Yep. And what would have been really even a kind of like more fun is to take this and make it to where it was uneven, like maybe do this, you know, cut this down here and cut that up there. You know, it doesn't have to be even. There's no law. Okay, so here, I haven't even tried these yet. The stripes and splatters 3D embossing folders. If we choose, see this stripes, I think we'd be concerned how they're going to line up with these stripes. So we're not going to use that. We're going to use the splatters. I'm going to call my husband and ask for something else. Keep your fingers. Oops, wrong button. And now there's two of me. This is very scary. Cecil, there's some brand new stamps and dies that were in a pile out there. Can you bring them? One day I'm going to be organized and yeah. Oh, thank you, Diane. Now, if this was, okay, now if this was very linear, you would definitely want to do this. You would definitely want to do this so that they, you know, at the same time and lining them up. Oh, yes, yes. let me just pop over here really quick. Now, hey, while I do, remember that when you, thank you. Oh boy, these are exciting stamps. Oh, that this week is the last time that you can get in at the early bird price for the mystery card. Now, if you've never been to our mystery card, I'm just going to tell you, it's more like detective card. Now, maybe I should call it that, only because it, you get to see the card while we make it. Cause you know, I think that that's a whole lot less stressful. I'm going to tell you, yeah, I was up until the wee hours this morning. And oh yes, those of you who are getting sweet treats, please do not think that somebody broke into your sweet treats, okay? But anyway, I'll tell you about that in a minute. So here's the thing. We're going to make a mystery card. I'll have it designed. We'll all make it together. You don't have to buy anything other than your registration to get in, and you make it with the things that you have at home, and you could be, you know, you could use your favorite stuff. You could use the stamps that you use all the time and the colors you use all the time, or you could stretch out. It's whatever you want. And then we play three games and we give away lots of stamps, inks, and paper, you know. And so, yes, and it's a great time. And the people that you like best on these live streams out there in the audience with you, yeah, those are the ones that show up. So make sure that you go and register before the price goes up when early bird is over. And, oh, you know, Marcy used to be a teacher. I think she was organized at one point. You know, I really do. But, you know, I think I need to, you know, because I think maybe in 5 years we'll move. And so I think I need to go around and start playing dead. You know, it's like, yeah, because my daughter doesn't want my stamps. However, when my granddaughter was here visiting, she went and said, "Grandma, maybe I should learn how to stamp so I can take over your business." I'm like, yeah, maybe you should. Yeah, oh God. I saw something and I almost went, oh, that's not positive, so I won't cut it out. But it said something about, when I need it, I can't find it. When I find it, I can't need it. And that is the story of my life on these live streams. Yeah, A-type personalities have a hard time watching me, okay? Yeah, okay. So back to this. So here you go. Here you go. Now, if you want to make that more pronounced, you just go and put that, you know, take some of the brushes, the blending brushes. Yeah, my daughter is more organized than I am, but especially since she got married. So yeah, I think maybe her husband's a neatnik. Who knows? Or maybe she just figured it was just better that way. Oops. Okay, so let's see. I made this a little bit longer so that I can put it in the middle and not worry about it sticking out. So let's see about where it is. It's about there. So we'll put that on first. See, that would be cute. Yeah. So here's a secret to helping with that. You know, we talked about spreading love, contributions. However, crafters have to have a lot of accumulations to make contributions. Okay. Yeah, I read this one the other day. One today is worth two tomorrows. But I like, the success in life should be determined by contributions, not accumulations. Okay. So, yeah. Boy, there's so many people who are catching, you know, things. And, you know, you think, well, it's not bad. You know, once you get something, it's not really bad. And so the only thing is, people don't realize that it's the after effects. Okay, so here's my little trick here. I go and take this and I'm lining it up here. And then I'm taking this and I'm lining it up here just to get an idea. so that I can put this in here and I know that we will be somewhat like right. There you go. Now this we're going to put on with glue, which is not in the holder. Yeah, this would be nice. That's gonna be my new go-to for having a nice background. One of these days I'll put glue on right, and then you'll be like, we'll be in wheelchairs. There you go. Anne is wonderful. I have no idea where we're going with this, but I do have a little in my head. And that's why I asked my husband to bring in some of my latest. Accumulations. Yeah. I didn't get it quite in the middle, but see, now at this point we can go this way or we can go that way, but I'm putting these on here somewhere. And it may not be a real fancy card, because you know, I'm more of a simple cut. I don't know about simple. I like things to look harder than what they are. Okay, hold on. Yeah, good idea. Put the top on the glue. Oh, yes. Thank you. Thank you for bringing that up. Yes. In fact, I'm going to go and get Domino's first license on Betty's birthday. That's my thing to do. And then, but go and make a $5, or it could be $20, you know, make 20 bucks if you can afford it. Okay. And just give it to your local animal shelter. We have rescue paws here. Every town of any size has some kind of no-kill animal shelter, and that's who you want to donate to, a no-kill animal shelter, because they, you know, they're just trying to make it. And you know, some of these dogs can sit a year in that place, and that's not good. So yeah, and I'm just gonna tell you, we have at least one brainwashed person here. I wish it was the dog. So anyway, back to this. Hold on. Let's go and get a stamp. Oh, not a stamp. I block for that. Oh, yeah. It would be at the bottom. There we go. I'm Amy. I'm thinking Smoky Slate, because it doesn't say. Whoa, that's pretty close to big. We don't have to make them this color. We could make them pool party, but I really want to put other colors on here to feature, and not necessarily the boots. Not necessarily, but maybe. And you know, we could do the watering can, but that could be a little bit going a different way than what I want to go. Well, I just happen to have this, so I'm not going to make a 4x4 out of that. Yes. Yeah, so anyway, Betty White is they're saying for Betty White's birthday, just go and donate to an animal shelter or something. You know, like my husband and I went to Thailand with Stampin' Up, and we went to an elephant preserve, and that's not the word for it. Sanctuary, that's the word for it. And we learned, you know, it's really not nice to ride on elephants. And we learned how they've really treated them very badly, worse than they had to, in order to control them because of their size. And they could get the same effect by just being nice to them, right? And we got to feed an elephant, and we got to walk around with them. That was just wild. You know, it was just, it was great. And it was, they used to use them for lumber and for, you know, yeah, for clearing trees and stuff like that in Thailand. You can't do that anymore, but people still do. And so anyway, yeah, it's great. So that's a place that's Phuket Animal Sanctuary. I think that's, or Elephant Sanctuary. I think that's what it's called. I think, I'm not sure. Because I haven't been there for a while, but it has shown up. Yeah, I like it. So I hope you're saying Deb is wonderful. Yeah. I hope you're saying Deb is wonderful. Yeah. Let me go over here and cut this real quick. Of course, I have to go and bang around these platforms. What did, you know, I can remember when Stampin' Up! got their first die cutting machine. And I can remember Shelley Gardner, our co-founder and then CEO, and she was up on the stage and showing us how it works and stuff. And I can remember coming back to my room and taking a break, and I went and called a few of my friends, you know, that were in my stamp club down in Sacramento, and I think I sold three of them before they even had them available. Okay, so what greeting should we use? And this, see, I think this is to go out of there. So, hey, I would have just gone and maybe put this over the top, not necessarily have everything coming out. Because that's, you can tell that's meant to come out of the boots, but we don't have to make it any certain kind of way. I know something I want to do that I haven't done. Ooh. And we don't even have to do this. I mean, that's what my husband brought in. That's what I wanted to bring out. Is it this one? Yeah. Here, check this out. Beautiful shapes dies. Maybe Patty or Marcy can tell us, or somebody can tell us what page these are on. I didn't get the stamp set, but I may go back and get the stamp set. But this is the beautiful shapes dies, especially for those of you. Yeah. Look at that. Bigger. Yeah. Look at this. Oh, we could use that. But that's a little bit small. That's a little bit small. Ah. I wonder how it cuts. Well, let's go and get these together and so we have some options. These could be pool party. Page 50 and they're $29. But look at these. Are these cool? And we're going to say goodbye to Joseph right now cuz he's putting weird things on. He's being weird. I don't know why these people all of a sudden, you know, yeah. Anyway, this is something that, well, we can cut it out and we'll see how it does, but let's see what these look like in pool party. But what greeting should we use? Rain or shine, I'm here for you. I was thinking a partial large circle, but it may be a little bit too, ooh, yeah, Linda Brady, okay. Get those dies. Yeah. Yep. I like how you think, Beverly. Yep. Okay. Pool party. Yes, this weekend, I was going, oh, I really want to go and tear apart my desk. I have an idea of what I want to do for my desk. And then what did I do? But, yeah, I went, no, I think I better get all the things out. So, oh, yes, I was going to tell you what happened with the with the mailing. So I have to tell you, I had everything all together, and all of the people who got all of the samples for the sweet treats, they those were in priority padded envelopes, right? Or padded priority envelopes. Yeah. And when I went to clean off the table where I, you know, because I did some of the stacking up at one point and then another one of the stacking up. So I go to clean off the table and I found the two different kinds of the little dots that, you know, that you put in shaker cards and the sequins and stuff. And they were all packaged up and they were all in little bags, but they were not inside the priority padded envelopes or the padded priority envelopes. Anyway, so I went and I went, oh golly. And the labels were on there for with the postage. And I'm going, okay, I know I could print those out again. And then, you know, oh boy. So what I do, I went and I slit a little slit about this much in there, and then I taped it up. So when you get yours, if it's in one of those padded priority envelopes, yeah, you'll see on the backside, there's, it looks like, oh, someone's been breaking in, you know? No, they didn't. I was putting something in. So yeah, happens to the best of us. And more often now that I'm getting more experienced. Okay, let's see what this looks like. Ooh, we could stamp that on there. And well, let's just see what it looks like. We might like it better. Yeah, that's awful light. That's awful light. I had that white piece here a minute ago. Did you watch where I put it? Okay, hold on. Okay, this is the tulip dies, and there's the otters. You can get that for free. See, look at. Ooh, awesome. And these are not my favorite tulips, but these, I love the sayings. Let today be the start of something new. Do you like those like that? Like, going, where did I put it? It's not like I don't have some spare white here, that's for sure. That's what you would have done, put blue on. Oh, duh, here it is. I'm like, going, where did I put that? Okay. So which do we like better? Do we like those or do we like these? I don't know if I like either one. Oh golly. No. Okay, so here we're gonna try another. I keep pulling this out thinking there's a stamp set in there. Maybe if somebody can just get me 3 extra feet here, that would be good. Then I'd fill that up. I don't know about you, but I'm from the camp that, you know, let no horizontal surface go uncovered. Yeah. This was easy to get to. So this, sorry, I'm using dirty blocks, but you know, Blushing Bride. Okay. Okay, there's those. I might like those. Only thing is Blushing Bride is so light. And this seems really light. And let's get out some. You know, when I first started stamping as a, well, you know what, first time I ever did a Stampin' Up! Party, I was the host. Yeah, I was the host because I was invited to one and I couldn't go. So I ordered and then I did it as a host, you know, because the lady lived like an hour from me. And I can remember that she went and brought a brighter pink. You know, I think a brighter pink might be it. I think I'm going there. I'm just stamping a bunch of stuff so that we have options. We could kind of see how the colors go together. And you'll notice that I don't, if you're wondering why I don't use the little padded here, it's because I have a full pack of grid paper underneath me. Underneath this. You know what? No, I think the pink might be it. The pink, I know which pink. The one I like. That, or else Flirty Flamingo would be good too. I was just trying to keep with that paper, but you know, there's nothing saying that we can't just go our own way. You know, they made a song about that. I just like to know where I put my little, conversation hearts. So I'd like to do a class with that. Not that. Well, I still use this. I think that's right. Would a different color boot work? Yeah, it could. We will look at that in a second. I just think this is too light. But who doesn't love pink tulips? Yeah, I think that's it, don't you? Whoop. Here, I'll move this. I got things here stopping. They're impeding my progress. What do you think? That's awfully bright. Yes, that's who it was. I was, first time I worked at a record store. Okay, I'm dating myself. I worked at a record store, and then later I managed a record store. And that's when Fleetwood Mac came out. And I was never much of a rocker. And so, I really never knew who Fleetwood Mac was until that point. I'm more of an R&B girl. If you're wondering where to get these, I know all of our regulars have these, but yeah. Yeah, you know, you could be bright and yet subtly bright, you know, kind of like that girl with the master's education that's really quiet at the party. Doesn't say much. Doesn't show off how smart she is. Yeah. Okay, we'll just keep our fingers crossed that I'm putting these in the right spot. I love that you helped me go and plan these cards out, you know, because it's like you're here with me. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. I can tell I'm looking a little bit to the left when I'm putting that on. So, okay. So here you go. So this goes like this, right? Have to go over a little bit. This goes like this. This goes like that. Hold on. Where is it? Where do the, okay, there you go. Ha, yeah, we are coming together. But anyway, this is where, and we, the dog gets like a little bone out of it. Yeah, this dog has more clothes and more toys than my other two dogs I've ever had combined. Yeah. But anyway, these magnets are great, and there's some other things that Stampin' Up! Doesn't carry that's where you'll find them. So yeah. So here we go. I think that gives you just enough, right? And you could, I'm gonna do something real quick. We'll see if it works. Just an idea, doesn't have to be. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Now we have a local stamp club that we're meeting over here tomorrow night. So if you're close to Yuba City, yeah, you can come. But we also have our pup club. That is our online stamp club. And I know Nancy, who's going to be watching later, she's part of that. And you just commit to spending $25 a month. And then every 6 months, you get at least $25 free. And then you get like eight projects in your email box.
Yeah.
Where do we want to cut this? I think I just want to cut two of them off. One, two. Yeah. And I wouldn't have to, but I kind of try to go with the flow. There you go. Here, right? Then I would glue, we could glue this on, or we could, the only thing is I would maybe, yeah, or else you could use dimensionals. I would glue this on, and it could even go off the bottom if you wanted it to, right? But it has to be far enough over so that you can get all of these flowers in here, right? You could even glue these on. But you definitely want to pop these up, because remember, if it gets too thick, then you're talking about more postage, ma'am. And it doesn't have to have a greeting on it. It could, in fact, I might even just cut, if I cut this off a little bit more, and then the pink will be over on top of that. See, look at that. Okay, let's do it. We'll look at it real quick. I'll be fast. And so that you notice I've got this up here, right? If you've never been here before, I have a lot of little things that I do different. And I don't know that I would put it directly in the middle. I'd put a little bit below middle, only because it's an awfully tall card. Look at, put this here, because you still want those scallops to show, maybe, or maybe you don't. That's up to you. And this is exactly how you would build it when you're putting it together. There we go. And, you know, yeah, there you go. Let's see if this shows up, Elaine. Let's show if this. Nope, it doesn't. She put a little monkey with the heart. Yeah. And then if I did it this way, then I could just put one of these small greetings up here. And I love these clear ones. Yeah. So I did start telling you about my first demonstrator. It made me think of it because of this stamp right here. It looks like a seed packet, right? At least it does to me. And actually, that would go well right there. Anyway, and we made a seed packet, and I might find it and show it to you. And the thing is like 25 years old, but it had potpourri in it. And I don't know if any of you remember that stamp that we used to have. But see, look at, you have room for Live Life in Full Bloom right there. That one doesn't work. This is just a bit large for it, so you'd want to put it up here somewhere. But I kind of like it just like this, and then just have a greeting right there and call it good. Yeah, I call it good. Just like I call you good. And I'm just really happy that you came and hung out with us today. Hey, you know, Domino's out there and he's, well, I have to eat before he eats. That's a subtle way for us to let him know that we're in charge. Yeah, right. And so, yeah, we got to get Domino his dinner. But, you know, if you think that I'm having a good time, you know, I got to tell you, well, yeah, I am having a good time. And I wish that you would go and, you know, just take a moment and thinking about joining my team. Right now, we've got a great special. If you're thinking the word become a demonstrator is scary, you can join and just stamp with your friends and they buy stuff and you get a discount, or maybe just do it all yourself. People do that as well. Just do it, because I got to tell you, it is one of the best things I have ever done. Yeah. And I'd love it if you'd be part of us too. Hey, come back on Wednesday. We're going to be doing something fun and wild, and who knows what we're going to get into. I just know it's going to be good and it's going to be better when you show up. This is Ann Clemmer and Domino from StamperDog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun.
Yes.
Into your day. See you Wednesday when we're live at 5.